Why do glycine and salt help with sleep? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Chris, thank you so much for taking the time to do this. I love it.
You're welcome. Thank you for coming.
Couple questions here about improving sleep. You'd made comments at previous podcasts about two things. One was glycine at bedtime, which I was doing about 3 grams. And the other is sodium chloride salt. I was doing about a half teaspoon, about 2 grams to help avoid having to get up to go to the bathroom. I found both of these things work. And would you mind elucidating a little bit the mechanism on how those things work?
Sure. The glycine is probably working primarily as acting as an inhibitory neurotransmitter and lowering core body temperature to promote faster falling asleep and deeper sleep achieved. And if you're, you know, the way that I think about it is, and I've talked to my friend Dan Pardy about this, who's an expert in sleep, is basically, you know, waking up or not waking up is largely the sort of coalescence of many different waking or sleeping signals. And so if, you know, having to pee is one of the signals that would put pressure on you to wake, the more you have signals telling you to sleep, the more that's counteracted. And so if you're in a deeper sleep and you have the same impetus to wake up from having a full bladder, you're less likely to wake up just because you've achieved a deeper state of sleep where you're less disturbed. And then on the salt is going to stimulate antidiuretic hormone or vasopressin, which is really a mechanism to regulate the concentration of solutes in the blood and make sure your electrolyte and fluid balance is proper. But by doing so, the way it achieves that is to reduce the likelihood that your bladder will get filled up with water, that you will have the urge to urinate it out. And so it's not really that part of it's not really acting on your sleep. It's really acting on your likelihood of having to pee. And so glycine's getting you a deeper sleep. Salt is preventing you from having to pee. And the two of those make you less likely to wake up for that purpose.
Yeah. Having to pee definitely interferes with sleep.
Yeah. Does that help along the, what you were looking for?
That does. Thank you.
Cool. Anything else?
That's it.
Okay, great. Thank you, Paul, for your question. Great to see you.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.